The mandible. Mandible is the largest bone of the face. It forms synovial joint in the skull and it is the only mobile bone. It develops from the first pharyngeal arch. Mandible comprises a body which lodges 16 lower teeth and a pair of rami, which is mainly for muscle attachment. Each half of body has surfaces, outer and inner. The outer surface reveals symphysis menti, mental protuberance, below that mental foramen, which gives exit to mental nerve and vessels, incisive fossa and oblique line, which gives attachment to the muscles. The inner surface shows myelohyoid line from third molar tooth downwards. In the lower part, there are, in relation to the symphysis menti, there are genial tubercles, superior and inferior. Above the myelohyoid line has a fossa, the submandibular fossa, which lodges the submandibular salivary gland. The submandibular fossa lies below the myelohyoid line. It lodges the submandibular salivary gland and the submandibular group of lymph nodes. These lymph nodes drain the side of the tongue. Above the myelohyoid line is the sublingual fossa lodging the sublingual salivary gland. The borders. There are two borders, upper border and the lower border. Upper border is the alveolar border for the teeth. And these joints are known as gomphosis. The lower border is also called the base. Near the midline, on each side is a fossa, the digastric fossa, which gives origin to the anterior belly of digastric muscle. On the inner surface, there is a myelohyoid groove which lies below the myelohyoid line. The ramus of the mandible. It has got surfaces which are lateral and medial. The lateral surface is flat and it shows few ridges. The medial surface has a mandibular foramen which leads into a mandibular canal and it opens outside at the mental foramen and it keeps on giving incisive branches to the teeth. The anteromedial boundary of mandibular foramen is formed by a tongue-like process which is known as the lingula. The myelohyoid groove runs downwards and medially. The borders. It has got four borders. The upper border forms the concave mandibular notch. The lower border continues with the posterior border at the angle of the mandible. The anterior border is thin and the posterior border is thick. The coronoid process is a triangular projection from anterosuperior part of the ramus of mandible. The condyloid process is expanded and forms the head. The head is covered with a fibrocartilage and it forms the very important synovial temporomandibular joint. Below the head is the neck, which is narrow. An anterior surface of neck has a depression which is known as pterygoid fovea. the attachments. The oblique line of the mandible gives attachment to the buccinator muscle. It extends down till the first molar tooth. The lower part of the oblique line gives attachment to depressor anguli oris and depressor labii inferioris. The incisive fossa provides attachment to the mentalis and mental slips of orbicularis oris muscle. The myelohyoid line on the inner aspect gives attachment to myelohyoid muscle in most of its part. At the posterior end, it gives attachment to the superior constrictor muscle, and just behind superior constrictor is a raphe called as pterygomandibular raphe. At the back of symphysis menti, the upper genial tubercle gives attachment to the genioglossus, which is a very important muscle, life-saving muscle of the tongue, and the lower genial tubercle gives attachment to geniohyoid. The digastric fossa gives attachment to the anterior belly of the digastric muscle. The deep cervical fascia is attached along the whole length of the lower border. Most of the lateral surface of the ramus gives insertion to the strong masseter muscle. The posterosuperior part of the lateral surface is related to the parotid gland, which overlaps the masseter muscle. On the inner surface, the lingula in relation to mandibular canal gives attachment to the sphenomandibular ligament. The medial surface of the ramus near the angle gives insertion to medial pterygoid muscle. The apex and medial surface of coronoid process and anterior border of the ramus gives insertion to important temporalis muscle. The lateral pterygoid gets inserted into pterygoid fovea on the anterior aspect of the neck. It is also inserted into the articular disc of the temporomandibular joint and the capsule of the important temporomandibular joint. Lastly, the lateral surface of the neck gives attachment to an important lateral ligament of the temporomandibular joint. The mandible is related to lots of nerves and vessels. The nerves related are all the branches of the mandibular division of trigeminal nerve. These are the auriculotemporal nerve at the neck of the mandible. The lingual nerve is related to the third molar tooth, and in extraction of third molar tooth, one has to be careful not to injure this important lingual nerve. Next is the inferior alveolar nerve, which passes through the mandibular canal and exits out through the mental foramen on the outside. Before the inferior alveolar nerve enters the mandibular canal, it gives a branch which is known as the myelohyoid nerve, which runs in the myelohyoid groove to supply the myelohyoid muscle and the anterior belly of digastric. At the concave notch above, between the coronoid process and the condyloid process, is the mesenteric nerve, which supplies the masseter muscle. These are the nerves. Now, lots of vessels are related to the mandible, these are facial artery. Facial artery is a branch of external carotid artery. It is seen on the inner surface of the mandible where it makes a loop, and then it is seen at the anteroinferior angle of masseter where it runs on the in between the facial muscles, and at the lower border of mandible an anteroinferior angle of masseter muscle, it is palpable and it is known as the anesthetist's artery. Next is the external carotid artery, which enters the parotid gland and divides into a superficial temporal artery, which accompanies the auriculotemporal nerve, and a maxillary artery, which enters the infratemporal fossa. The myelohyoid vessels run in the myelohyoid groove. The mental vessels are seen from the mental foramen. The inferior alveolar vessels enter the mandibular canal, branches of maxillary artery. The masseteric artery runs in the concave notch. This is also a branch of the maxillary artery. The salivary glands are also related to the mandible. On the posterosuperior part of lateral surface of the ramus and also on the deeper aspect of the mandible is the largest salivary gland, the parotid gland. Also enclosing are some of the lymph nodes. The submandibular gland lies below the myelohyoid line, also enclosing the submandibular group of lymph nodes, draining the lateral aspect of the tongue. Above the myelohyoid line lie the sublingual salivary gland. The lymph nodes present have been said. They are preauricular in relation to parotid gland, submandibular in relation to submandibular gland, the fascia. Fascia, the deep cervical fascia, is related to and attached to the lower border of the mandible. Pterygomandibular raphe is attached behind the third molar tooth, and actually it gives origin to the superior constrictor muscle and buccinator muscle. The sphenomandibular raphe attached to the lingula of the mandibular foramen, and it is a remnant of first arch. The stylomandibular ligament is attached to the angle of the mandible. It is not related to any arch, but it is a thickening of the deep cervical fascia. Joints in relation to mandible, there are 16 joints with the teeth. These are gomphoses. Fibrous joints, the two temporomandibular joints on formed by the head of the mandible, and symphysis menti in the center. The muscles of first arch are related to the mandible. These are four muscles of mastication: the lateral pterygoid, the medial pterygoid, the temporalis, and the masseter. And anterior belly of digastric and myelohyoid. Out of 8 muscles, 6 muscles are inserted into the mandible bone. And there are other muscles of the second arch, muscles of facial expression, and the buccinator muscle.